Are you serious? Are you serious? Folks, we got some news coming out of South Korea. There's been a building that has collapsed at a college during a concert. I'm going to thank Nick of New York for this report. But South Korea's President Park Hine has called for a full investigation into the collapse of an auditorium near there in a college facility. 10 people are dead. At least 100 have been injured. Emergency staff has worked through the night. This happened last night, a little bit after 9 p.m. local time there in South Korea. More than 560 college students were believed to be attending a concert when part of the auditorium roof caved in. 9 of those killed in the disaster blamed the weight of snow on the roof. 9 of the 10 were students. Now, the weather is also thought to have slowed down the rescue efforts. It's a heart-rending that so many lives were sacrificed, and through investigation must be carried out, says the president of the country. So again, very sad news, very, very, very disturbing news. Also, I know Japan, let me just check here quickly. I got some reports that Japan has also had more people die due to the snow. I want to thank Nick of New York also for this report, which is actually coming out of Reuters. And it is the second Japan snowstorm now leaves thousands stranded as the death toll rises to 23. The snow has choked the roads. It has cut off thousands on today, Tuesday, February 18th, 2014, as parts of Japan struggle to dig out from its second storm in a week. What? The death toll rises to 23. Train services have been suspended in some areas after the Valentine's Day storm dumped more than a meter of snow in parts of central Japan, blanketing the capital with record snow for the second weekend in a row, snarling the airline traffic and slowing production at some Japanese automakers. So it's very, 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 it's a very freak storm, very, very strange. It's an apocalyptic moment taking place in Japan, a nation that's already been riddled with grief since the 3/11/11 earthquake of 8.9, which was the fifth largest quake in recorded human history. After that quake shook the ground for 6 minutes, a tsunami came inland 6 miles and left 6 nuclear reactors melting down in the aftermath, knocking the earth off its axis 4.8 inches and actually making our days shorter by 0.1666 seconds. Well, we'll just keep praying. These things are happening. We're living in the last days, and we need to pray one for another. And you need to understand that Christ is coming soon. These are just the birthing pains. This isn't the, you know, this is nothing compared to the woes and the woes and the woes that are yet to come. I'll talk to you in a few minutes. God bless and give your life to Jesus Christ. We're in the last days. Are you serious? He is coming soon. Very soon. God bless.